Okay, so good afternoon one and all. Today we will see a new poem in English and the poem name is It Can Be Done. So basically what is given in this poem that if you want to be a changes or development in your life, not only the life but for the society also, at that time you have to take a risk, you have to expect, you have to accept adventure. Accept the adventure in your life. So that time you have to be say it can be done. You cannot use it can't be done. All right. So you have to accept the challenges in your day-to-day life. Then only you can face the development. You can see the development of your life. So first I will learn, recite the whole poem for you, and then after I will explain each stanza one by one. Okay. The man who misses all the ferns is he who say it can't be done. In solemn pride he stand aloof and greets each venture with reproof. Had he the power he would effect the history of the human race, we would have no radio or motor cars, no streets lit by electric stars, no telegraph, nor telephone. We would linger in the age of stone. The world would sleep if things were run by men who say it can't be done. Anonymous. See, student, whenever you find last anonymous, that means the poem has no poet. Okay, that means the poem has no poet. All right, now let's start. Let's start the explanation now. The man who misses all the fun is he who say it can't be done. What is the mean of this first stanza? Here in this poem, the poet clearly disapproval of the people. They disapprove. It's not approve of those people who say the words or who always recall this, that kind of word. It can't be done. It can't be done. So if he tells us that the man who say that something cannot be done is the man who misses all the fun of their life. So never ever use this kind of words, it can't be done, which shows the negative effect. You always have to say, you always say it can be done. Always think of positive in your mind. Okay, now see the next. In Solomon pride he stand aloof and greets each venture with reproof. Now Solomon means what? Solomon pride means that kind of person who look very serious, grand and important. Okay, aloof means what? Unfriendly. Aloof means what? Unfriendly, without getting involved in anything. They don't like to involve in a group or in any particular activity. Venture means you can take a, you can say adventure or dangerous or risky task. Reproof. Now what is mean by reproof? Reproof, that means a negative comments. Criticism, that means a negative comments. All right. So basically what the poet wants to say in the second stanza, that kind of person who looks so important, who looks so very serious, he remain unfriendly and make a distance with the other people. They don't like to get involved in anything, in any particular activity or any person. They don't like to involve. And he greets every fresh project. Greets, that means welcome every fresh project with the negative comments. Every fresh project or the dangerous or risky task. If those kind of person get a risky task in their day-to-day life, they always accept it with the negative comments, because in their mind they already fix that it can't be done. So that kind of person, it is dangerous for our society. Why? Because if each task and if each task or the dangerous, risky adventure, they avoid it and they keep in their mind a negative society. Okay, let's move further. Okay, now see the next stanza. What is in the next stanza? Had he the power he had affected the history of the human race, we would have no radio or motor cars, no street by electric stars. Now what is the meaning of this next stanza? In this next stanza, the poet want to say, if he had the power, which kind of person? Those person who always have a negative comments and always saying it can't be done. If that those kind of person have the power, they will do effects. Effects means was destroy or wipe up. What they will destroy? They will destroy the history of the human race. In a history, a man create and invent lots of things, okay, for the development. They do creative things, they do the invention also. But suppose at that time period, if those kind of men who say it can't be done, if they are there, so we won't be able to enjoy the development and inventions, luxury items which we have today. Okay, so here basically the poet want to say in this stanza that suppose it can't be done, those have a negative comments or the those have the negative thought, those kind of person can remove out all the inventions or the development or luxury items which we have today. Okay, we would have no radio, no motor cars, no street lit by electric stars. We don't have all this electronic motor items which we have today and we enjoy it and make our life comfortable. We won't be able to enjoy all this electronic machines. If that time period, the person, the negative person, if say it can't be done. Now next, come to the next stanza. No telegraph, no telephone, we would linger in the age of stone. Now here linger means what? Linger means remain or stay behind. Linger means remain or stay behind. The world would slip if things were run by men who say it can't be done. So here in this poem, in this stanza, what they actually want to say that we have the lots of things. We do a lots of changes for make our life comfortable, for make our life luxury. Okay, so we create a different electronics things like a radio, like a motor car, like a telegraph, like a telephone. If suppose those kind of person who will run, who will take care all this thing, those person who's always so always thought it can't be done. So we won't be able to enjoy all this kind of luxury items with us. We don't have the telegraph, we nor have the telephone. Okay, we always be a linger. Linger means remain or stay behind, a backward class. We always be a behind. Our country cannot be face or cannot be enjoy the development. Understand? Our suppose if that time, suppose in a Stone Age time, if the peoples cannot be think that it can be possible, we have to take a risk, we have to take a dangerous task. If they are not accepted the dangerous task, see, so today we won't be a civilized person. We will not be a civilized person. At that time, in a Stone Age man time, the people will take the accept the challenges. They observe what is in their surrounding. They observe all the things which is present in the natural resources. So they utilize, they function very well. And then after they do a invention. And through the invention, we can create our life luxury. As you can see in the students, before, at the age of Stone Age man time, there is a no house, there is a no shelter, clothes, vehicles, animals. They don't know how to identify wild animals, domestic animals. Slowly, little up, they're observing, they do creative, they do inventions, they make a shelters, they make the clothes, they make the wheels, they make a carts. They identify the useful animals, the dangerous animals. They identify which plants, which herbs is utilized for us, how to do a farming, how to create cultivation crops. They do invention, they do the changes, they modify their living of standard, their living life. And then after today, we are a civilized person. And slowly, they become a modernized also. They invent telephone, they invent computers, they invent all the electronic motors. Then after we get the light. Okay, so slowly we become started the development. We started invention, electronic items or bridges, so many things. But it is possible if the person are accepted, it can be done. If the person is saying it can be done. If person is saying it can't be done with the negative thoughts, he always be alone, never involved, never take and accept the dangerous risk or dangerous task. So you cannot be face the new thing. You cannot be face the new thing, a new luxury things in your day-to-day life. Understood? For that, you have to accept the dangerous and the risky task in your life. So basically what we see in the today's poem, the poem want to tell you that don't be afraid to accept the new challenge in your life. Okay, if you face a new challenge in your life, you have to be faced with a positive thought and accept it, because when you create something anew, a new things will give you a pleasure. Okay, and it's changed not only your life, but the society life also. Okay, so here our poem is over. I want to show you the meaning of such hard words in solemn pride. What is the meaning of solemn pride? Here it means looking very serious, grand and important person. Aloof. Aloof means what? Aloof means what? Separately, without getting involved in anything. Venture. Venture means adventure, a dangerous, a risky task. Reproof, that means criticism or negative comments. Okay, a person who always have a negative thoughts. Effects. Effects means wipe out, remove. Effects means wipe out, remove. In this poem, what they want to say, that if suppose a person run by the those person who always say it can't be done, that person can remove out, can wipe out all the inventions items, all the development things which we have today in our country. Okay. So students, our poem is over. This is a very short and nice poem. Okay. One more time, I want to read this poem for you. The man who misses all the fun is he who say it can't be done. In Solomon pride, he stand aloof and greets each venture with reproof. Had he the power, he had affected the history of the human race. He would have no radio or motor cars, no street lit by electric stars, no telegraph, no telephone. We would linger in the age of stone. The world would sleep if the things were run by the man who say it can't be done. So here the student, in the poem, the poet wants to say the world will be inactive and it will be in a deep sleep. We are never able to enjoy all the things like a radio, motor cars, telephone. If the world is run by the men who say the world, it can be done. So you always accept the new challenges and you always keep a positive thing in your mind and always say it can be done. So student,